it raps like a heart attack. That's fatal heart impact. Past painful scars, in fact, I blast tasteful bars and packs. I back up my actions, fact, don't ask, grab reactions, jacked, attack with every word, then act with class as they hear me snap. I got nothing to lose, cause I fought and felt the bruise. Now I'm not the one confused, call the shots and they produce. I ain't lost, I'm finally loose, pick a new silver excuse. I need the views to boost me through a new abuse of being used. Everybody wants a peace now, y'all can rest in peace now. You're dead to me, so peace out. Remember, you just freaked out. Keep ready for defeat.
Alrighty. Hello, hello, everybody. This is Kirusho here, and now, whenever we last left off with this series, quite a lot of things were going on. Now, in the last part, Deku and Amelia, they sat down and had a chat. Amelia revealed to Deku that somebody from another alien species could have been following them whenever they went out before. And Amelia, yeah. Ultimately, she had to spill the beans to Deku and tell him that she was the princess of an alien species that, after leaving their homeworld after being caught between a war through different intergalactic empires, it's a long story. Yeah. Deku, he learned quite a bit. He found this to be very shocking, to say the least. And Amelia, she wanted to show Deku more, because she has the ability to at least show Deku visions and images and even memories. Now, Deku can do this strange ability as well. However, for Amelia, it's a bit more personal. And the way she was trying to at least show Deku, Deku, he may or may not have been misreading it a bit. However, he did explain to Amelia exactly the way she was coming off as. Now, with that being said, we do currently at least have where Deku and Amelia, they tried to ignore that little incident. Deku, he never really said anything about it. And Amelia, she was a bit too embarrassed. However, they did at least continue on the conversation about exactly what and exactly how things are out in space. And she would at least try and explain little tidbits here and there. However, if something is a bit too out of Deku's range to understand, she would leave it out. Now, we do at least have where after going out for a few times a day, or even just at one extended time per day, Amelia, she's starting to get accustomed to a few things around Earth. Well, Deku, he has been a bit more careful now, using his car to take them to safer spots in the city. You do still have the fact that Amelia, she is very surprised by everything. And the fact that Deku takes her to places where there's more people around, and even the fact is that Deku himself is comfortable being around those areas, there have been a few times where Amelia, she may or may not have gotten a little bit lost. Now, Deku and her, they do still spend this time together. And Deku, we do have the day Amelia, she reveals to him that her superior was able to get her a human identity. And Deku, he was very intrigued by this. Now, Amelia talked to Deku about exactly who she would be, as the human name Amelia was present and then at least another last name. And Deku, he was actually very intrigued by this. Now she at least has records, so she fits in better. However, there's also at least another problem. She has a few different things listed as previous job experiences, and so far, Deku doesn't believe that these things could be real. However, upon at least doing a bit more research, there are very odd and strange jobs that are closer to being in an automated industry. Now, basically it means that if a robot could do that job, the person could do it as well. However, they're basically there to make sure everything can flow a bit more smoothly. Now, this isn't that Deku, he does actually see as a bit more viable, or at least a bit better, because it's basically like this. People wouldn't ever expect to see someone in that job anymore. So if you have that experience, or at least different areas like that in your resume, you can still get at least good spots here and there. Now, Deku, he's very pleased by this. And right now we do have where, after he does come home from his first day of work, he does set down a briefcase. And Amelia just asked him exactly what he was doing today. Oh. Nothing much. Got things clear with the doctors. Got things clear with my boss. A lot of different people at the precinct were happy to see me again. I was gone for over a month. Deku flipping open the case. Him throwing it open, as he does go to pull out an entire stack of files. And Amigdash asks Deku exactly what he's doing. Oh. This stuff. Let's see. While I was gone, a lot of cases, they came in. It sucks. And, well, some people who were handling cases that I would have been given, they gave me some of the ones they didn't really think they needed too much dealt with on them. Right now I got simple cases, and they're all kind of annoying.
Really?
Yes. A lot of them, they're very simplistic right now, and at least a few of them, they're a bit more in my range. So let's at least start. I can start working on these at least tomorrow, or a bit later today. If I'm going to be going out, I don't want you going with me, all right? But why not? Amelia, I explained earlier to you, or at least the other day, that whenever I got back to my job to maintain an appearance, that me and you might have to cut down our trips a bit, okay?
Yes, but I mean, it's invalid to my research.
Invalid to your research? Deku turning to her. As he has hold a file in his hand, he does get to walk over. As he has asked her exactly what has she been doing all day, besides at least eating some snacks and being on the computer. What has she been doing other than looking at old TV shows where things aren't even exactly like real life? They are exaggerated versions of it. And Amelia, she does actually feel these words kind of hit, as Deku does get to tell her that all she's really been doing is sitting around and watching exaggerated versions of reality, and barely even really looking into things that could benefit her species' research. Last time he checked, she was hiding out here. And right now, she cannot really do too much here. So, he is going to maintain his life while she stays here and stays safe, because he already has enough on his plate to deal with as it is. Now, Amelia, she does kind of get a bit annoyed. While Deku, what he's saying is somewhat accurate, it also does at least still hurt her feelings. However, she does sort of understand how Deku is. Deku, he's a very guarded individual. From what she knows about him so far, he is serious. Along with that, there's the way he just, his demeanor is. Whenever it comes to very personal relationships, he doesn't have a lot. The ones he does have are all professional. Theirs is, she doesn't even know how to define it, but then there's the fact that he just tries so hard to be, well, himself. Now, Deku would come home a few hours later, as Amelia says, find that Deku, while he is tired, he does at least talk about how he solved a few here and there. And she's very excited about this. As she asks Deku exactly what he did today. Not much, not much. Let's see. Solved a homicide. Well, got some information. And at least found out where a few stolen goods were. Stolen car, armed robbery. Solved a vehicle theft. And, well, yeah, that case is still sort of open and shut, but not really shut. I can't talk about that one. These events, they all sound very, what? I was going to say exciting, but you do not seem to share the same sentiment. Not really, no. People die today. Listen, it's not like reality. When you gotta stand there and take everything in, you feel a little bit more human. Along with that, you know you are not bulletproof. I thought your species was aware of that fact. Okay, Amelia. Let's make a bit of a deal. I am out of alcohol. And my bottle of whiskey, it's gone. So, let's go to the store. How about that, okay? Really? Yes, really. Because I believe that I have a full day's work ahead of me tomorrow, along with teaching you some sarcasm. Okay? All right. Well, what will we learn first? Okay. Now, just try speaking ironically, and I'll teach you a few gestures, we can go from there, okay? Amelia, she does at least hear how Deku's talking about this. Him and her talking on the way to the store, as you do have where, whenever they're at the store, you do have Deku paying for the alcohol, and at least going to turn and ask Amelia if she's coming with him. Her actually going to run back over to Deku, as she has hold up something in her hands, asking exactly what these things might be. Those are candy bars. Will we be able to get some? Okay, first off, let's see. Deku reaching out his hand. Him pulling one from the stack, talking about how this one here sucks. And then there's actually this one here, which, well, it is sort of good. It's basically the same as this one here. But if it's the exact same, then what is the difference? Branding. What is that? It's stupid. Okay. Well then, what about the ones we do have remaining? Sure. The guy does go to ring up the candy, as is actually ask Izuku if she's with him. Yes, she is. Foreigner. Really? But her Japanese is almost flawless. Yeah, she's a visitor from overseas. Half Japanese, you understand? All right, that's strange, but then she wouldn't really exactly be a foreigner. Her mother was Japanese, she grew up in America, and recently she's here to visit. I see. All right then, have a good day, sir. Deku's going to walk away, ending the conversation very quickly. And as both of them they're walking down the street, you do have Amelia just ask Deku exactly why he was so quick to leave. He was asking unnecessary questions. Oh, I see. Then that was advisable, correct? Very much so. Okay. Well, let's see. The basics of sarcasm. All right. I don't exactly know what to do. Now, Deku does try to start her off very small. As whenever he does talk about how a certain way to make your voice sound, you do have where a few people, they do actually step up in front of Deku. As Deku, he does, is going to bring his hand up and stop Amelia. As whenever someone, they do start to talk a bit, you do have where they do try to at least allude to Deku that he might be stepping on their turf. And Deku, he does go to at least try and make this a bit more peaceful. All right. We're just passing by. All right, we don't want no trouble. Okay, old man, listen to me. You sort of brought trouble here when you walked through our area. You know, this is a place special to us, so you got to pay a bit of a fee. Or you can hand over whatever's in that bag over there. Just some cheap alcohol. Cheap alcohol. Last time I checked, alcohol wasn't exactly too cheap. Especially at that store down there. So you're at least locals, right? Oh yeah, you could say that. We're local, sure. At least we know the area pretty well. Is this sarcasm? Amelia, now is not the time. Oh, this girl here, yours? Very pretty. Maybe me and my friends can show around the area. Get her a few drinks, maybe? Hang out a bit, you know? Now, Deku did just stare at the person in front of him. Him going to bring his hand into his pocket and go to pull out a badge. As the mother kid has stared at it for a second, he did just stare back at Deku. All right, kid.
Listen, here's the deal. I can make a phone call. In about 2-3 minutes, my guys can be here and put you in handcuffs. Or, option B, you can try to fight me, and I pull a gun, and I shoot whichever one of you tries to rush me. And one of you ends up in the hospital, and then you all go to prison. Option C, you all try your best to fight me, and I just completely beat the shit out of all of you. How's that? Oh, come on. You're just a cop. You can't shoot us. Never said I couldn't. Now, Deku does get a reach for his waist. As he thinks if he just shows off his gun, they'll all go running. However, the moment Deku does get a grab at his waist, you do have where his gun is missing. And Deku is very surprised and caught off guard by that. As he is just going to look down, before he is going to look behind him. As there's somebody standing there, holding up Deku's gun. And Deku just stare at it. Shit. But wait, I didn't even sense him. So kid, I'm assuming you're a freak? Oh please, don't call me that. Come on. I'm just using my gifts, you know? Besides, I mean look at this little thing. The person went to hold it up towards Deku. And Deku just stared at the person. Really? You think you can threaten me with my own gun, kid? You really think so? Oh, come on. Just hand over all your money and we'll leave. That's all we want. Now, Amelia, she just does stare at Deku. She doesn't know exactly what to do in the situation. Well, they could easily use their powers and just fling all of them away, or just freeze them in their tracks, or just really just do anything in the situation that would completely expose them. Deku has been telling her, in his head, to play it by the book. Play it his way. Alright, kid, listen. Deku stepping forwards. And the kid is going to bring his head over the trigger, finding that it's actually a lot heavier to try and squeeze down on. Shit, what the hell? Alright, kid. Listen to me. Deku is stepping right in front of the kid as he does just hold the gun directly to Deku's chest. That trigger is weighted. Nothing's going to shake it loose. It can't accidentally misfire. Along with that, those guns are special. You want to know how exactly much impact is behind each bullet? How much force you can put behind it? Let me put it this way. You could blow a hole straight clean through me. And you can hit your friend right back there and then hit into a concrete wall behind him about probably 30 feet away. And the bullet will just cleave through it straight like butter. So, do you want to pull that trigger? Come on, I'm waiting for it. The person just staring at Deku. Their hand is starting to shake, and Deku is going to bring his hand upwards slowly, going to grab the person by their wrist, as he's going to tell them that they don't really need to be shy. Him bringing the wrist upwards directly up to his forehead, telling them that this will be a cleaner shot. This will make sure that they don't miss. Deku is just going to lean his forehead directly into the tip of the barrel, telling them that if they're going to take the fucking shot, then take it. However, if they're going to play street punks, they should exactly know what it means to play a little fucking delinquent. A little boy pretending like he has the world on his fucking shoulders. Pretending to be the boy who has everything given to him. However, the moment he has his world challenged, he crumples like a piece of fucking paper. You're crazy, man. You're fucking crazy. Am I, kid? Or am I just speaking from experience? Now, me and the girl are gonna go. If either one of you try and stab me, try to come after us, I'm breaking your fucking legs. You're a cop, though. I'm a cop. Yes. However, I have a witness here saying that you are threatening me and trying to rob me. I can classify that as self-defense. I am a detective, not some run-of-the-mill fucking officer. Now, the kid does go to let go of his gun. As he's going to pull his
finger straight through the slide and talk about how he's a fucking detective. They need to get the hell out of here. Now, allow them to go running off. And Amelia should actually ask Deku if he really was truthful or at least honest with them about exactly what they were doing. And Deku is going to hold his gun in the proper way, going to put it back down into his holster. Ah, fucking kids. No. What do you mean? You were not truthful with them? I was very truthful with them. These bullets, they can cleave a hole straight through my fucking skull if they wanted to, Amelia. Granted, they couldn't do too much after that. What do you mean? Once a bullet's fired, it doesn't have that much distance on it. Granted, these are still metal bullets, but even then, they can lose momentum fast depending on how hard the object they hit is. It's a standard frame of propulsion. I don't know how to explain it to you. It's all science-y, but even then, Kid wouldn't have been able to pull the trigger. Exactly what do you mean? Deku is just going to bring his hand down, pull his gun, and he's going to flip it in his hand, talking about how detectives, these carry specialized guns. Along with even the standard model, they do come with every police officer. Their guns are all wired to a database, and his fingerprints are in that database. What do you mean? It's quite simple. If I try to hold this gun, I can fire it, I can shoot it, I can do whatever the hell I wanted to with it. If I wanted to, I could take pot shots at a dumpster. However, if somebody who isn't registered to my firearm tries to fire it, they can't. You might as well just be trying to, what, drag a tree stump that's still rooted in the ground. However, if you're even still another officer, you can still use my gun. It's a simple tactic. It's a lot more complicated than that, though. Complicated? Yeah. While I was terminated from being a police officer, my gun was suspended, meaning that it was basically a locked firearm. Your firearm was not usable during the time? Nope. However, now it is. So, there is that. But you were... I was what? Now, Amelia, she's trying to think. She has seen many different things in her life. However, the fact is, there's something that cannot compare to that. The coolest thing she's ever seen is one of her guards try to foil an assassination effort on her father. However, she has to say that that beats it by a large margin. Deku, from what she saw, was not afraid to literally have his head blown off. And the way he was acting, calm and in control of the situation, it was something like a movie. It's not all fake. That being what she is thinking. And as Deku and her Ryu continue to walk back to the apartment, she's at least trying to comment on this. Trying to ask Deku about more things he may have done on his job. And rather, if he can tell her if any of them, they were exactly sort of like that. Amelia, I'm not talking to you about this. But come on, you have to. I want to know. I'm curious. Nope. What do you mean, nope? Can't I know? You could, yes, but you can't. Can't or won't? You won't, because I'm not telling. All right, then. Well, then, I guess I'll just have to hide a bit more information about space, then, won't I? Yes, you will. Huh? What? I'm... That was... I don't even know what that was. That was my attempt at sarcasm. Am I doing it right? I want to say yes. Really? And you ruined it. Well, I'm still mad at you. I mean, come on. You're saying everything I'm seeing on TV is fake. And then that is real? What you did?
Come on, you have to give me that. I'm just so curious now. What other things have you done?
Now, Deku is gonna freeze as he was sitting down in his apartment and about to bring a glass to his lips, as he does think about something that he's done before. As an image just flashes mind in Deku, he does get to just look down at his knuckles. He doesn't want to say anything about that. Now then, that being said, I do hope you guys enjoyed. Have an amazing night. I'll catch you guys in the next part.